Well, joining me today is senior advocate Nalini Chidambaram, also, of course, the wife of ex-finance minister P Chidambaram. Mrs. Chidambaram, your reaction to this verdict saying that basically there was no scam in the 2G case?
I'm very happy about the judgment. The special judge has held that the prosecution miserably failed to prove its case. This is very happy development, because especially for the Congress, unnecessarily the UPA government was described as a corrupt government because of the 2G scam. This cost the Congress dearly in the 2014 election. Now that the judges said that the entire prosecution has failed miserably, that the taint which was attached to the UPA government has now been removed, and I am very happy about it.
But Mrs. Chidambaram, in what role are you speaking today? Are you speaking from your perspective as a senior lawyer, as the wife of an ex-finance minister who was also part of the UPA government at that time, and of course a mother of someone, Karthi, who's currently facing CBI charges and investigations also in a matter similar to this?
No, the entire accusations against my family is all without any basis, and we have moved the court. Therefore, all the matters are sub judice. Therefore, I do not want to comment on that.
The CBI, however, has said that it will appeal this verdict in a higher court. Your reaction?
Yeah, because the entire indictment is against the way the CBI has conducted the case. I haven't read it fully. I have read the judgments in bits and pieces. But the accusation is against the way the CBI has conducted the trial. Therefore, definitely CBI has to go on revision before the High Court. And we have to wait the outcome of that. But as of now, I think the judge has written some 1,500 pages, and the judge is considered as a very honest and efficient judge. Therefore, I think it will be very difficult for the High Court to set aside the order of the special judge.
Finally, ma'am, when you speak today on the 2G case, considering that your family is also facing charges and investigations by the same agencies, what perspective are you speaking from?
No, I am speaking both as a lawyer and as a person who is happy for the Congress, because unnecessarily the image of the Congress was tarnished by this false propaganda about the 2G case, and therefore they also did miserably badly in the 2014 election because of this false propaganda. Now that the judgment has come that there is no criminality involved in that, therefore it is the stand of the Congress has been vindicated.
Nalini Chidambaram, thank you very much for joining me. Thank you. What's your view on it, sir? Do you agree with what Mr. Salve said, that this hype, this perception created, but where was the scam? There were procedural lapses, but no proof of criminality or actual bribes. Go ahead, sir.
No, as far as the case is concerned, the case was not concerned with the wisdom of the policy. Now the case concerned with the propriety of whatever choice the government made. The issue was rather narrow. The question was whether Raja had actually acted in a manner which was unwarranted and behaved in a manner which in some way defeated an extant policy or took a role which was actually unacceptable for the government. What the court has actually found is that insofar as the accusation against Raja is concerned, is unfounded, not because a wrong did not happen, but because it's inappropriate to say that Raja alone was responsible, which was the thrust of the charge sheet. What the court has actually found was that there was a leaking telecom ministry, which is the reason why the corporates were aware of things before they were actually formally announced.
Right.
The court has also found that as far as the PMO was concerned, because the thrust was the PM, Prime Minister was misled. Mm-hmm. The court found that the Prime Minister was not misled. In fact, there was what the court said, coordination and synchronicity between the Ministry of Telecommunication and the Prime Minister's office. The court also said
no,
that as far as the external minister is concerned, the external minister was kept in the loop and the finance minister did not take any
objection. No, I just read out that bit from the verdict which said that the facts are actually misrepresented.
Pardon?
I just read out the bit from the verdict which the judge Saini says.
Please read the verdict again.
Yes.
Please read the verdict again. Please read the verdict again. The judgment, feed it into your computer and just feed the words coordination and synchronicity.
Mm-hmm.
And you'll find that this was, and so the PMO is concerned, there was mm-hmm. coordination and synchronicity between the Ministry of Telecommunication and the PMO. And the court actually found out as to what happened with the files was not placed on record because the relevant people from the PMO's office were not called. The Prime Minister himself, the former Prime Minister himself was not examined. And insofar as the other aspects are concerned, to actually say and isolate Raja, because this point is the key. Because in a parliamentary form of government, when there is a decision which is taken by a minister,
it's
which is actually in sync with what the policy of the government is, you cannot isolate the minister and single him out for prosecution. So
of
the thrust
course,
of this particular case is not insofar as
but I was actually quoting a different
that.
Part of the verdict
the
view, which says that the PMO started. Officials misrepresented facts to the then Prime Minister. So that's the part of the verdict it's quoting to. But just to say, sir, the larger point, and again, we can pick this verdict as over 2,000 pages with
the
three
that
different
was
the judgments.
That was
but
the
larger point of no criminality in the scam never existed, which Judge Seni said. Go ahead.
No, the criminality, of course. The question here is, please understand, there are two issues. What the Supreme Court said was, insofar as the change in policy is concerned, was incorrect, and you can't change the rules in the middle of the game, which is an undisputed proposition, for which reason it struck the licenses down. And that issue was not there before the criminal court. What the criminal court is seized off is a far narrower issue, not the larger issue with which we are concerned, and dealing with precise accusations against particular individuals to decide whether they are culpable at all or not. So
right.
The issue of culpability of those who were accused actually dealt with, and what the court has found was that you cannot hold them culpable because whatever was initiated in the ministry through the officials which are part of the ministry, and the government as such was privy to what was happening to suggest that what Raja did was not something that he was actually beating his own trumpet or pursuing something which was his own insular desire.